Zenyatta on the outside now strikes the front, and it's We'll take 4 wins in 2 days, and very proud of our team that we have in place.
Another head right, it's Ed Pearl, all by herself. Ed Pearl, with Eddie left in the tank. Essential Quality's gonna do it. Essential Quality, and Nick's go goes all the way at the dirt mile.
And she's just like a machine.
As they come down to the line, she did it again. Mademoiselle Girl and Florent Giroux.
Speaking of Brad Cox, here we go again. His fourth win in the Breeders' Cup this year.
And Jerry Bailey turns him loose. The response was devastating. And Mike Smith lets Arrow get loose.
Devastating! Whoa, look at this! Undoubtedly now, a living legend, Zagata! 59 seconds flat.
Go power.
Go power.
Hit it.
Lena Justice is coming up. The inside is coming. Lena Justice, a great blur in the stretch. It's Lena Justice, a left to back foot on the stretch. And here comes El Hurt, storming on the outside. El Hurt right. And here comes El Hurt. Gets there at the final drive.
Denise Body.
Kentucky Derby winner.
Everybody, Mike Beer here.
Dan Illman, Mike Beer, race number 3 at Santa Anita on Sunday. One of 2 competitive stakes races on the card.
I am Brian Zipsy, and as always, I have the excellent pleasure of being joined by my co-host to the East Coast. That's my ship and help.
This is Jared Horak for TheRunawayHorse.com.
Hello everyone, Matt Chapman here of Sky Sports Racing.
And Ascot tomorrow has 2 graded races, which we'll cover first. And
well, we know what sort of a year it's been, but even 2020 couldn't stop Aidan O'Brien.
It's Order of Australia! He's 73-1 in the Breeders' Cup Mile!
Awesome!
Hey everybody, it's Jay Privman along with Marty McGee. Thank you for joining us throughout this elongated Kentucky Derby trail.